Well, I was thinking of, maybe we could go to the next slide. I was thinking, as I was listening, that there's an intriguing issue that's here, which is that I live in the suburbs, as do you. I live in Westchester. And we all kind of are dependent on the center of New York, and imagine it's the center of culture and all of those things. And I think we don't necessarily have a habit of building full communities where all of the components of community and civic life actually exist in a town. And I think this is such a wonderful commercial district in the middle of Greenwich that the opportunity exists to be a different type of town where there would also be a cultural institution of enormous civic importance right here where it belongs on the town green. It's a different way of looking at what a town can be because it can have its own central focus and still be, obviously, as we all are, dependent on New York City for the extraordinary artistic agenda and events that are there. But my purpose is not to speculate on those issues. I wanted to, and I think I'll move so I can see what I'm talking about. I wanted to look at the plans with you a little bit and just talk through what's here and what we propose. And the first floor is, oops, it is, it's working, it's right here. And the idea of the first floor is, and unfortunately we've taken these without a site plan, but right here is the side that faces Greenwich Avenue, where you can see my pointer. And in this drawing, the yellow indicates the space where you move, what we call circulation space. And there's a main door here, and then we've put in additional doors surrounding the theater. You may notice that we've reoriented it so that it goes this direction as opposed to the direction that it currently is situated in. And we've built a whole new stage house. And that has to do with building a true proscenium arch theater with fly space so that all kinds of drama can be here, and it will have it will also have an orchestra pit here, which comes up and down. So this is what we've all been talking about as the 400-seat theater. And in here is a lobby that surrounds it. There's a cafe that would be outside. And then next to it is the what we've been calling the Black Box Theater. And then there's a lecture hall over here, which is another place which could be a place for other performances. If you go downstairs, this is the other floor of the Black Box Theater. It's a two-story space, so we've cut through. You'll notice everybody keeps talking about the bearing walls. They go right on the side of the corridors, so we're staying within the rigidity of that and respecting it. And down here are rooms for various artistic purposes. All of the gray space is support space for the theater, and that little bit of blue there is the orchestra pit, which comes down from the theater above. If you go upstairs, there are more spaces in the tan color for artistic endeavors of all types, and they're, I presume, still subject to change as different people influence this. And then the administrative space is shown in red, and the additional space here, this is for arts, visual arts, up on the top floor under the skylights. This building, when it's all done, will give us something like 50,000 or 52,000 square feet of space devoted to the arts. And I think that's a very important amount of space to have in one place. And of course, many, many things will be going on at the same time in this place. And there'll be a gallery down here, and the whole hallway can be used as a gallery as well. Let's see the next slide. This is a view of the lobby where you enter right here, and it takes you upstairs to get to the second level of the theater. So there's a balcony that comes down. I'll show you in a section in a minute. This is a view of the Black Box Theater right here, looking at the second floor. I think we get about 150 seats in that. That's a flat floor down below. And actually, one of the ones we've just built at Manhattanville College, we have not only the flat floor, but we have bleacher-type seating, which is actually theatrical seating, which slides out so that if you want to terrace seating, you can have it in a space that also has flat floor potential, which allows the drama to be put on in a variety of ways. And the next slide. This, I wish were bigger, but it's here. This is a section through the theater. And what you're seeing is that this is stepped seating. Here's the orchestra pit down here. This is the stage. You can cover the orchestra pit with the thrust stage here. This is the fly space, which is more than twice the height of the proscenium arch as it must be to fly sets. Here's the scene shop behind this. And then you can see the balcony up above it and this double height space through here. This is a space where there's a little rule of thumb when you're doing theaters that you can see facial expressions if you have very good vision up to about 70 feet away. So it's if you want to go to the theater or to the opera, you'd like to be that far away. Our seating, the farthest back seating, is 50 feet back from the stage. And the sight lines are perfect. And so any seat in the house is a wonderful seat. So we're going to have 400 seats where everybody can see everything that's going on. And this should be an extraordinary place. And then if it's supported by all of the other events that will be going on, it should make a wonderful thing.